Things got crazy north of the border. The Atlas Games women ended semifinals with a bang by blowing up the points race. We'll show you how on this episode of Inside the Leaderboard. Hey everyone, Tommy Marquez here with another edition of Inside the Leaderboard presented by Thorne, personalized scientific wellness. And today I want to pay homage to the absolute bonkers points race that went down at the Atlas Games competition for the women's division this past weekend that unfortunately we didn't get to see play out in person. To do so, we're gonna map out the path of each athlete in the top 10 after each event and their movement on the leaderboard since over the weekend results dropped in two event batches. This is the leaderboard after event one, and strap in because it's gonna be a bumpy ride. After event two, to close day one, Alexis Johnson moves up seven spots after a top three finish. Mackenzie Flinchum drops six spots out of the top five, along with Sydney McCallishan, who drops three spots as well. After event three, and all dim muscle ups, not a single athlete stayed put. Mackenzie Riley jumps up to the front of the line. McBailey Rail enters the top five for the first time. Alexis Johnson drops out, and Paige Semenza enters the conversation, moving up five spots and onto the bubble. Close day two, the heavy snatches shifted everyone on the leaderboard except Mackenzie Riley. McCallishan moves from eighth to second, Rail drops from fourth to ninth, and Emma Lawson enters the top 10 for the very first time this weekend. The lengthy event five shakes things up again. Johnson and Rail both move back up into the top five. Prevo falls out of a qualifying spot for the first time, and McCallishan falls back out, going from second to seventh in just one event. All of this to set up what would have been an epic finale in person. All of the top five spots change hands. Prevo jumps five spots up into first. McCallishan moves back into the top five, and Johnson and Annika Greer both drop out. The top 10 athletes move a total of 21 spots on the final event alone, which would have been an absolutely insane live competition to watch. These are the types of points races we've been looking for, and these are the types of races that are only made possible by a clearly defined cut line and a cohesive qualifying system. That's gonna do it for this edition of Inside the Leaderboard presented by Thorne. Check out thorne.com, the official supplement partner of CrossFit, trusted by US national teams and more than 100 professional sports teams. Up next, we have the Last Chance Online qualifier. Be sure to check out all of our coverage of that, and followed by the games. Tickets are still on sale now, and you can get those at games.crossfit.com.